How are you today? Keep so quiet. Can you hear me fine? All right, yes. Thank you. Okay, so last time we talked about the Fourier series and we mentioned about the inner product, right? Why do we have to mention about that? Because we have to consider about the orthogonal property. And you can see we use the orthogonality property to find the coefficients of the Fourier series, right? That's what we did last time. And I also see your homework. All right, so how are we gonna do that? Last time I gave you the form of the Fourier series. F of x is equal to a naught divided by 2 plus the summation, right? You run the index n from 1 to infinity. Okay, the summation will be of an cosine nx plus bn sine nx. And I have shown you guys how we're gonna find a naught, and we found a naught equal to 1 over pi times the integration from negative pi to pi if our period or the periodic function has the period of 2 pi. And start from the negative pi to pi, it's gonna be the symmetric interval, right, of fx dx. What about the an? The an, the form is really similar to a naught, except you have to multiply the integrand. Besides just have f of x, you have f of x times cosine nx. How about bn? The first problem of homework 2, I asked you, show how you're gonna find bn, right? By using the orthogonal property, okay? So what we did, you're going to have, actually, you only have to do the inner product of fx and the term on the right-hand side here by multiply both sides with the cosine nx, right? Okay, so what we're gonna have here for bn, you're going to have f of x times or the inner product with the sine nx. And it's gonna equal to what? On the right-hand side, you're actually gonna have a half, right? Inner product between a naught and sine nx. I just recall the formula of this equation here. Let me call this equation will be equation star, okay? And okay, so recall from star. All right, and then we move here. From star, you just do inner product of both sides. Okay, from star, we do inner product. With star by using sine nx. So we multiply the left-hand side with the sine nx and do inner product with the first term. After that, with the summation, but at the end, we only have what? We change the summation to the integration, right? So we're going to have plus the summation of an of cosine nx and sine nx. And then we have plus the summation of bn sine nx and sine nx. By using the orthogonality property, remember, you have this term going to be 0, and this term totally different function, so it's going to be 0. So now you have only this. And you know that the inner product between the sine nx and sine nx, this one equal to pi. Therefore, you're going to have pi, bn pi, right? Times pi. It's equal to the inner product of fx and sine nx, which is equal to what? Integration from negative pi to pi of fx sine nx dx. And that's how we got bn equal to 1 over pi integration from negative pi to pi of fx sine nx dx. Here we go. This is how we show it. And the other one, we move on to the function, right? Still going to be the periodic function, but right now, the period is not 2 pi anymore. The period becomes 2L, right? When the period is 2L, and we want to find, okay, let's move on here. When it's 2L, and we actually going to find the form of the Fourier series in terms of L. And sometimes, you know, you can change the Fourier series of periodic 2L into the Fourier series of periodic 2 pi. Okay, don't get confused about that. Now I'm going to show you how we going to find two forms of Fourier series. The first one, okay, keep this in mind. The first one, it's gonna be Fourier series of period 2 pi. The other one gonna be still the same function, but it's another form. It's a Fourier series of the same function, but we consider with the periodic, the period of 2L, okay? One will be 2 pi and one will be 2L. And how are we gonna do that? Remember, I mentioned about this, okay? The one in the circle. We're gonna use this to transform the knowledge of Fourier series with the period 2 pi that we already found above. Found where? Found here. Okay, this is the Fourier series of periodic function with period of 2 pi. Okay, and I believe you all can remember it now. And by using this, use this relationship, x equal to lt divided by pi. So instead of having fx, we're going to have f of lt divided by pi. And you can see by using this transform, wherever that x equal to minus l, we change it to t variable, right? T will be minus pi. And when x equal to l, t gonna be pi. All right, so let's summarize it. We're gonna shift from the interval negative l to l becomes negative pi to pi. And then the variable, instead of having x, we're gonna use t, okay? All right, and we found out, once we have it, we know that g of t, okay, by using the formula that we have, it's a naught divided by 2 plus the summation a n cosine nt plus b n sine nt. Okay, you see the form? It's exactly the form of Fourier series over the period of 2 pi. But now, if you don't want to use the period of 2 pi, because right now our function has a period 2L, okay? Has a period 2L. You probably want to write everything in terms of L, okay? And how are we going to do that? So we're going to change variable bt, we're going to use here, because x equal to lt over pi, So T is pi x over L. Wherever be T, I just plug in pi x over L. So A naught, we keep it the same. And N T here, I just change it to N pi x over L. And similarly, this one gonna be pi x over L too. So we don't have T anymore. What about the A naught? The A naught here, we cannot, okay, we know that by using x equal to LT over pi or T equal to pi x over L here, can change the interval from negative pi to pi becomes negative L to L. What about DT? Okay, DT is gonna be what? Pi over L dx, because we wanna change everything back to x. So you have to change DT to dx. So I have 1 over pi times the integration. The interval here has been changed from negative pi to pi becomes negative L to L. You see? And dt is pi over L dx. So I get pi over L dx. Pi just cancel out. It's just constant. So now we have 1 over L times the integration from negative L to L of fx dx. Okay, we got the form of A naught in terms of period 2L. What about AN? We do exactly the same thing. So we get 1 over pi. You convert the interval here to negative L to L. And instead of having GT, GT is what? Is FX. And here's gonna be cosine NT. So T is pi X over L. So becomes cosine N pi X over L. Similarly, dt is pi over L dx. I just cancel out the constant pi. So I came up with the AN form. And then I ask you guys, can you find the form of what? Find the form of BN. Okay, did you try? I saw somebody still like submit late. Somebody still have notification say missing. So it's okay. Now you can give my words to your friend. If they really want to come to study this course with us, they can still be able to submit homework later. I won't cut off any points as long as, you know, we have the rule. The rule is try to do every single problem. But after you register in this class, the rule gonna be a little bit pop up like, besides submit all the problem, I would like you guys submit it on time. I don't want the system happen like a red letters, say warning or missing like that. Yeah, because the course has been created by the education side of the Faculty of Science. So it's not just me that take care of this course. The Google Classroom, but we still have other staff from other division taking care of this as well. So it's gonna be great if you guys, you know, can submit everything on time. All right, and so the score gonna be, I'm going to post the TQF3 for you guys on the Google Classroom, the update one, okay? So you know that we, okay, before I do this, I really want to show you this one a little bit so you won't miss anything about the score. Okay, I have changed the score, and yeah, I think everybody should know about this. So the homework part is going to be 20%. I'm not sure how many homework will you get, but it's just some kind of exercise, you know, do some practice on that. How about the written exam? It will be split out half and half. So 40% will be on the midterm exam, and the other 40 gonna be for final. What about the rubric? The rubric here, you see? So you're gonna get full score, definitely. If you show our work and submit on time, and you're gonna get half of that, half of the score, okay? it's just like the ratio. So let's say each homework costs you 2 points. If you submit all the problem on time, you get 2 points. But if I found that, okay, you didn't submit all work, or you submit late, your score gonna be 1. Or if the full score is 10, you're gonna get 5. Okay, so I'll try to submit it on time too. And this is gonna be the rescale of the grading system. Last time we mentioned about 0 to 49, right, to be F. So above 50 gonna be D dog. But right now I have changed it. So only 0 to 39 will be F. Let's say if you get 39.1 or 0.01, I'm gonna kick you up to be D dog. So pretty much I don't think I'm gonna see F in this class. Okay. Yes, Thanathat. Right, you just call me. Is that right? วิชานี้มีชิ้นชิ้นไหมครับ No, we don't have it. What do you mean? Cheat sheets. As I mentioned, I probably give you guys the table. Remember the table last time? Do I have it here? I probably have it here. The table, remember? That's just for my meeting. Remember the formula table that I gave you guys? Yeah, I think this one probably helped you a lot. I may give these 2 pages to you on the exams, maybe both midterm and final. So at least it's gonna save lots of time, you see, because you have the form already. And yeah, in case that I give you like this kind of problem, case 5, it's gonna be a little bit messy, you see. So many variables you have to find. So if you have this paper, I think it's gonna help, and it should be enough for the exam. Oh, I think you are worried about the formula, right? Thanathat? Okay. Seem like I can read your mind, huh? Okay, so let's come back. If I think you guys should get really good grade in this class, at least should be B boy and above. So don't worry about it. Okay, what about BN? Okay, some of you did it right and some of you got it wrong for some reason. Maybe just a typo. Okay, how are we gonna find BN? BN comes from what? It's equal to 1 over pi, right? And we change the interval to minus L to L times what? Times f of x. But here it's going to be sine of n pi x over L dx. So when you cancel out the pi, you're going to get 1 over L times integration minus L to L of fx sine n pi, oops, sorry, I should change dt too. Dt gonna be pi over L. Okay, my cancel here. Don't do it, okay? N pi x right here. And right here, I mean this pi over L dx. Here we go. So you have bn equal to this. Okay, and this gonna be, you can use our formula here when the period is 2L. See that? when the period is 2L. Actually, I have the summary of the formula for you on the last page. If you keep moving down, you see the last page, the Fourier series for a non-periodic function. So if you have non-periodic function only 0 to L, you can get this form. I mean, you're gonna see more detail after this. Or this form, you get this form. If you do the even extension, you get this form. If you do the odd extension, how about the Fourier series of periodic 2L, you see? It's exactly what we did, but it's turned out to be this form because we consider only non-periodic function 0 to L, and you see we have the 2 multiply right here because you have to extend it to the other side to make it symmetric. Instead of having period 0 to L, you're going to move it from negative L to L, and that's how we get the 2 right here. Okay, you're gonna see it shortly. Next one, let's consider this. So now you have the form right here. Okay, let me summarize it real quick for you. Okay. Therefore, for the function, okay, with I would say the Fourier series of periodic function with period 2L, so our t equal to 2L, what you gonna get? It's going to be f of x, okay? So if, let's say, our function is fx defined on the period negative L to L instead of negative pi to pi, okay? Just like any symmetric interval. So our fx can be written as n0 divided by 2 plus the summation n from 1 to infinity of an cosine n pi x over L plus bn sine n pi x over L. Okay, this is what we have. And what about the coefficient a naught, an, and bn, where a naught is 1 over L integration from negative L to L times the fx dx. Similarly, an gonna be 1 over L integration from minus L to L of fx times cosine n pi x over L dx. And the last one, bn, is going to be 1 over L integration from negative L to L of fx times sine n pi x over L. And what I just spoil you guys is here. If I change this to 0 to L, it's only half of this interval, right? You're going to get the 2 pop up here. 2, 2, 2. Because you do this extension to the left or to the right. Okay, never mind, you're gonna see more detail on that. Next one, let's see this example. I give you this function fx equal to x when x is between negative pi half to pi half, and is equal to pi minus x. So where exactly that we talking about? The exact location. Okay, let's consider here for a little bit. You see this? This telling you that the t equal to 2 pi. The t equal to 2 pi. Okay. When you consider this, you know that the function is actually defined on fx is defined on negative pi half to 3 pi half. You see that? The given function, they're talking about the interval negative pi half to 3 pi half. Here and here. So where exactly on the graph, if you do some sketching, when you sketch it, right here is negative pi half, and this gonna be the 3 pi half. So actually, this is the given graph. And you can see that the period from here is exactly what? 2 pi. So before we be able to use the Fourier series over the period of 2 pi by using the formula star that we mentioned at the beginning of the class, we do some kind of shifting, okay? We do some kind of shifting. So I'm using exactly the length 2 pi, but now I consider this function from negative pi to pi. See? Oops. Are we going to get exactly the same thing? Oh, actually, I should draw the first one first. Okay. So the way you find a naught, as long as the interval or the periodic or the period is 2 pi. If you use the first picture, you can use this formula. But if you use the bottom picture, you can use this formula to find a naught. It's just example of how you find a naught. You see it? But you can see the period still be 2 pi, exactly the same thing. So if your function has period 2 pi, you can use this form or you can use this form, doesn't matter. What about the an? Okay, the top part, they just use the interval from negative pi to pi, so they consider here. Right here to find an. What about the bottom? The bottom they use from here, negative pi half to 3 pi half. To find an. What I'm telling you right now, you don't have to follow exact the rule. Like it has to be negative pi to pi. It could be what? Like negative pi half to 3 pi half. Okay, similarly to this. So this one they use here, negative pi to pi. And the bottom one they use from negative pi half to 3 pi half. Okay. Okay. So this one corresponding to this one. All right, so similarly, this is how we give you the form. Yeah. And you can see here, the formula, because our L, right, turned out to be pi or negative pi, you see here, this is still gonna be 2L equal to 2 pi, right? So n pi over L is n pi over pi, see? Just one more thing for you to recognize how we calculate. And this just some simulation, you know? When you do the integration over the period, maybe like negative 5 pi to 5 pi, and see the pattern, the graph gonna keep coming back to the same shape because it's periodic function, and period it means the length that the graph gonna repeat itself. Alright, next one, next definition. Before we move on, so you have to know exactly what's the even function and what's the odd function. About the property of even function. Even function must be satisfied f of negative x equal to fx. And if you sketch the graph, okay, note here. Graph will be symmetric with respect to what? Y axis. But for odd function, this one is even and this one is odd. F of negative x is equal to negative of fx. And this graph gonna symmetric with respect to origin. Remember? The following graphs are some example of odd and even function. The first one is odd or even. Panya, the first one is odd or even. The first graph is an odd function or even function. Panya ka, are you there? Oops, hi Joy. Our next one, Kittinat 603. The first one is odd or even. Okay, odd. Very good. So this one is odd. Really? Yeah, really. Because if you check the value, you're gonna see f of negative 2. Let's say f of negative 2 is exactly negative of f2. You see that? What about the second one? The second one is odd or even, Chachompu? Even, very good. Okay, this one is even. So if you see the value, at least, okay, like maybe f of negative 1, okay? Just some example, f of negative 1 equal to f of 1, okay? Number three. Thanathat is odd or even? Thanathat is odd or even? Number three? Thanathat say? Odd, very good. Okay, and number four, similar to the second graph, so this one is even, all right? And the bottom here, you know, psi will be odd and cosine will be even. Okay. So it's kind of clear that you guys know what's the odd function in even function. Let's see the remark. Odd multiply with the odd, you're gonna get even. Really? Let's give it a try. X multiply x cubed. Okay, odd and odd. You get what? X to the fourth. Even. We just saw the graph here. And if you have even function multiplied with the even function, here we go, we get even. The even function, usually if you talk about the polynomial gonna have power as an even number, like 2, 4, 6, 10, okay? If you multiply the even with the odd, you're gonna get the odd, is it? Becomes the odd number, odd power. And so for even and even, for example, I just add up 2x squared plus 2x squared, oh, it turns out to be 4x squared. See, the function is to be x squared, nothing changed. Or even though you subtract like 3x minus 1x, you get 2x. nothing changed about it. But if you do some integration over the symmetric interval, minus C to C, it's the same thing that you have double, right? Or two multiplies integration from 0 to C. Technically, if you do some integration, let's say this one, you just calculate and you just do the calculation of one side. Maybe from 0 to C, okay? And then you just multiply 2. But if it's odd function, the integration over the symmetric interval, you see here? It's gonna cancel out. Eventually, you're gonna get 0. Okay. Now, let's get back. If fx is even function, okay, here we go. Now we're gonna consider case by case. If our fx is even function with period of what? 2L. Oh my gosh, we just talk about this period, 2L. Then the Fourier series is supposed to be in this form. Remember, fx equal to a naught over 2 plus the summation a n cosine n pi x over l plus b n sine n pi x over l, which is deep. And a naught a n gonna be exactly this form, the one that we just proved above, and you just did the second problem of the second homework. But since we know that the Fourier series will be this form, but f is even function, hey, we talk about this, which is deep. This one is even, right? This one is even. Actually, this one, if, because we know f will be even, remember, you see, we can write a n instead of this form. It's gonna be 2 times the integration, you say times 1 over l, but the integration here, instead of having the interval of integration here from negative l to l, we just do 0 to l, you see, using this one, property 6 above. This one we use remark 6 above here. How about a n? Okay, cosine is even, you see that? This one is even, this one is even, so this one gonna be even, the whole thing gonna be even, and this one is still gonna be even. Here we go, we can use remark 6 again. See, you have to stick out here to multiply the interval. Instead of having negative L to L, it turned out to be only 0 to L. See, half of it. What about BN? BN gonna be 0. Why? FX is even, psi is odd. Even multiply odd, you get odd. And over the negative L to L of odd function, it's gonna be 0, right? This one from what? Remark 7 above. So no BN anymore. Therefore, if your function is even function, the Fourier series gonna reduce the form to only this form, see? And we don't have BN anymore. So what about BN? No BN. Here we go. No BN. Similarly, next one. Any question so far? Okay, I guess it's still simple, so you shouldn't have any question on that. How about if our function is odd? It's odd. Instead of having this, you say it's odd. So the integration of this one gonna be what? Zero, because f is odd over the periodic interval is gonna be zero. For an, this one is odd and this one is even. It turned out to be odd, right? So the integration gonna be zero again. Except the bottom one. The bottom one you have odd. Sine gonna be odd. Remember odd multiply odd? Which one is that? Odd multiply odd. You got even. See? Remark one. Even. Therefore, we going to use remark one. Odd multiply odd, you get even. So when it's even, you can use remark one and remark what? Remark six. Is that right? You see, becomes even function. So it's double of the half interval from 0 to L. 1 and 6. This is how we got this form. Therefore, if our function is odd function, the Fourier series reduces to this form only, the summation bn psi n pi x over L. So we don't have a naught and an. So we don't have a naught and an. Okay? For odd function. But for even, we have an and a naught, but we don't have bn. Okay, come to our problem here. See example 7. Okay, see example 7. This function is odd or even or none. Anybody knows? This function is odd or even? Example 7 is odd or even? This one gonna be even, right? Yeah, keep the chat. This one gonna be even. So when it's even, what about the period? Period equal to what? Supichaya, period equal to what? The period. Period is the whole thing. From negative 2 to 2. From here to here, tell you about the period. T equal to 4. Or if you don't see that, you can see this number. You see? The period gonna be 4. So what we get from here? But T, the period 4 here, represents by 2L. Therefore, we have 1L is 2. Okay, I don't know, maybe the idea that you mentioned 2 might be like URL already. Okay, it's okay, as long as you know where to put it on. Okay, since this one we have f is even, therefore, in our Fourier series, we know that bn gonna be 0. Ta-da! At least it saves time because it's event function, so bn gonna be zero. Here we go. Let's go ahead because this one they just want us to find Fourier series. To find Fourier series, we need to find a naught and an. Let's do it. We need to find a naught and an. So what about a naught? A naught equal to what? It's even. Where is it? Here. It's gonna be. I mean, you can use this formula, or you can use this formula. It's okay. It doesn't matter. It's end up with the same thing. So I'm going to use this formula. So I have 2 over L integration from 0 to L of fx dx. What's that? It's 2 over 2 because L is 2. Integration start from 0 to 2. Of what? The function gonna be 4 minus x squared. And then dx. Do the integration. The 2 and 2 cancel out. I have 4x minus x cubed divided by 3. Do some calculation from 0 to 2. Plug into in that, I get 8. And then minus 8 over 3. So we get 24 minus 8, 16 over 3. Here we go. I get one number, a naught. What about an? Okay. An, the formula gonna be 2 over L integration from 0 to L of fx times cosine, right? N pi x over L dx. Okay, here we go. Plug in the number. You have what? You have 2 over 2 integration from 0 to 2. The function is 4 minus x squared times cosine n pi x over 2 dx. What do we need to do here? Integration by parts, is that right? Okay, we need to do integration by parts
from here.
For integration by parts, you don't have to use the formula. You can use the shortcut way. I mean, I don't mind. So for me, I'm gonna choose one side to be the side that I have to take derivative, and the other side will be integration. So I'm going to put the 4 minus x squared on this side, and I'm going to put the other function cosine n pi x over L, which is over 2, on this side. See? So this side you keep doing derivative. The first time you're gonna get negative 2x, the other time you're gonna get minus 2, and the last time it turned out to be 0. Stop. What about the integration side? Integration of cosine, you're gonna get sine, right? Gonna be sine of n pi x over 2, and then you have to divide with the coefficients of x. So flip it over, multiply with 2 over pi. N pi, actually. Similarly, this one, integration of sine, you're gonna get negative, but you have negative of 2 over n pi square times cosine n pi x over L. Oops, 2. and last time. Okay, keep the negative the same, but here gonna be 2 over n pi power 3 times sine n pi x over 2. And then I just keep using the sign here. Gonna be plus, minus, plus, minus, and then cross multiply like this. The last row, you just do straight multiply and do some integration. So what do we get? The answer is going to be 4 minus x squared, okay, from here, 4 minus x squared, multiply with this, multiply with 2 over n pi times sine n pi x over 2. This is the first term. Second, minus minus becomes plus, and then we have minus here, so it's gonna be minus 2x times 2 over n pi square times cosine n pi x over 2 and plus. Okay, right now come to this one. Plus minus becomes minus, another minus becomes plus. That's how I get plus. 2 times 2 over n pi cube times with the sine n pi x over 2. Okay, close the bracket. Do some calculation from 0 to 2. What do we get? Up to here, one thing that I would like to give you guys note. When we talk about cosine n pi is equal to minus 1 to the n, and sine n pi is going to be 0, okay? So keep this in mind. You are going to use it a lot. Okay, let's plug in. When you plug in x equal to 2, what do we get? Plug in 2, 0. Plug in 2, get minus 4. Times 2 over n pi square, right? You plug in 2, cancel out. So here gonna be cosine n pi, and cosine n pi is negative 1 power n. Okay, you plug in 2, sine n pi becomes 0. Okay, this is the group that you plug in to. Minus, now you plug in 0. You plug in x equal to 0, sine 0 becomes 0. Minus, you plug in x equal to 0 becomes 0. And this one, sine 0 becomes 0 again. Here we go. Let's simplify the form. You get what? 2 squared is 4, 4 is 4, 4 times 4 is 16. So we have 16 over n pi square. And now I actually have one more minus. I just combine with this term, times minus 1 to the n plus 1. Oh, almost done. Now we have therefore the Fourier series of fx equal to what? It's equal to a naught divided by 2 plus summation n equal to 1 to infinity of a n cosine in pi x over L. You plug in the number, so you're gonna get where is it? Okay, we have 16 over 3 and divided by 2, so it's gonna be 8 over 3, and the other one gonna be our an, right? We have 8 over 3. It's 16 over 3, right? Divided by 2, so you get 8 over 3 plus 16 over pi square. I'm going to plug in inside the summation, and I have minus 1 to the n plus 1, or divided by n square times cosine n pi x over 2, and this is gonna be your answer. Not bad, right? I know you can do it. Okay, next one. We have known that a periodic function f x with period of 2L, okay, 2L, has the Fourier series in this form. Okay, we have seen it again and again. I believe you can remember it. And now, instead of consider the function with period 2L, okay, we will consider it. You see, they use the word, we can restate, okay, change the form, that a periodic function fx with period of t has a Fourier series as this. Actually, you need some more information put here. Let t equal to 2L. So wherever be L, we're gonna have t half. So it's gonna be just like half angle. You see, y will be L, but we let L equal to t. So here, L is half of t, half of t. L is half of t. Okay, y will be L, we just plug in half of t. That's it, nothing new from here. It's just like changing the form, you know? Nothing much. Next one, 1.3. What about if we have non-periodic function? Remember, we mentioned about non-periodic function. So, the function just give you like a half of the full function from 0 to L, the half interval like this, 0 to L. When you do this kind of non-periodic function, let me give notes to you here. For non-periodic function, you have three ways to extend, okay? We have three ways to write Fourier series. What about these three ways? The first way, you have to do the even extension. Or expansion. Next one, of course, you have even, you have to have odd extension. And the last one, we do half period. So instead of having non-periodic function, you probably have the function defined only 0 to L. You do the odd extension or, let me erase here. Let's use the word extension. If you extend to all our event. Okay. The period here gonna become negative L to L. But for event, it's just like the cosine function. And for all, you probably have to deal with the sine function. What about the half period? Half period, you're gonna have both cosine and sine function. Okay, let's see more detail. I just give you the overview of this section. The first one, they said if fx is not periodic and defined only on the interval 0 to L. Here we go. We'll use half range expansion. Okay, they probably use expansion. Half range expansion, that means you have the graph on this side, which is kind of like four along this axis, and see the graph on the other side, you see there? Symmetric picture. And now we have extend this function that defined only 0 to L to be a function defined on negative L to L like this. Therefore, when you write the function, remember this one gonna be the Fourier series of fx with periodic to L, right? Here we go. Therefore, we are this one, let me give you more detail. I don't want you to get confused. What do? We do expand to this side, minus L. So from here to here, we do even expansion. See, do expansion to the other one. And actually, the one that we got here, because we make the graph, now this one becomes what? Even, right? Even function. So when it's even, this term gonna be zero. This term will be written in this form. This term will be written in this form. And this form, actually we have the name for it. It say Fourier cosine series. You plug in cosine here. Change the name to Fourier cosine series is. Okay, here we go. Similarly. Next example. How about I have this function? Exactly the non-periodic function, because I just give you the range will be 0 to L. But now you just do some odd extension to this one. See that? When you do the odd expansion, right now this f gonna be odd function over the period of 2L instead of having L. And this one will be even function over the period of 2L as well. And from here, remember when f is odd, this term will be 0, this term gonna be 0, except this one will be in this form. And we have the name, this one is called Fourier sine series. Okay. The last type, let me put here, case one. Even expansion, and this is gonna be case two, odd expansion, and of course this one gonna be case three. It's gonna be what? It's gonna be using the regular expansion. Okay, this one we just use half period expansion. You just expand exactly what they gave you, So they give you only to 0 to L, you just keep expand another 0 to L, to the left and to the right. Whatever, I just do expand exactly the same way, like that. And the period here is still gonna be L. Not 4. See here? The period here, it's just, you know what here, when you do this, it's exactly that you copy itself. Okay, for more understanding, you copy itself. And you see here, instead of having 2L, you know that T is exactly wherever be L, because it's just T, right? As you know, T equal to 2L, so wherever be L, you plug in T half. You see? Half of T, half of T, half of T. See that? It's plugged in here. So wherever be L, you plug in half of T. What about the Fourier series? Because you know, L equal to half of T, so wherever T, it's just like 2L. You see? Therefore, from here, it's like switching the form, you know, nothing much. So from here, you just have A naught as like 2 over L of 0 to L of fx dx. Similarly, this one, you see the interval? It's 0 to L, 0 to L, 0 to L. And here, exactly the same form. Except, the key right here, you can use this form or you can use this form. It doesn't matter. But for this case, I recommend you guys, if you extend as an odd or even function, you choose one. And then for the size series, you do odd expansion. You just calculate a bn, but for the even function, you just do an and a naught. But for this one, if you not sure, like, you know, I don't choose either way. I don't do the odd expansion and I don't do the even expansion. So I'll just do the regular expansion. Okay. You're gonna have like this. You just do half integration 0 to L. You see? And here, from full period, negative half t to half t, you just do 0 to L, and here you're gonna be double of it. So 2 over L times 0 to L, multiply this. And here 2 over L, 2 over L, you see? And here still be cosine, so instead of having n pi over half a t, you're gonna get n pi over, what, L over 2, so you get n pi to n pi over L, because actually this one comes from n pi over L over 2, right? This one is like n pi over t, but it's L over 2, like that. See, like half of it. Mm-hmm. So that's how you flip it, the 2 over to the numerator. This is how we get. Okay, for remark, for all three cases, we only integrate on 0 to L to obtain the coefficient a naught, an, and bn. Therefore, we don't need to do the real half range extension on this side. Okay, in computation, just do one side only, and then you just multiply 2. All right, homework 3. Let's do which one? Let's do number 3. This one gonna be your homework 3. So homework 3 is supposed to be turned on by next Monday midnight. Okay. Should be only one problem. I mean you have due Monday,
Monday the what? Today is the 19th. Next Monday is gonna be 25th. Okay. Do Monday 25th. By midnight.
Alright. One problem. You have solution already. Just show me some work. And let's come back to the last page. Therefore, if you have a non-periodic function, define only half range, remember? You can do this one because of Fourier series. In this form, you do the even extension. Note here. Recall, give you like that. When you do this graph, you do some extension to this side and this side. This is how we do, and you're gonna get this form if you do odd expansion. That means you do expand on this side, and this one gonna be the regular Fourier series for the half length, like this, copy itself, you're gonna get this form. The way you remember, it's just like double, you see, of the integration from 0 to L, and here, usually it's gonna be n pi over L, so it's like n pi over L over 2, yeah, look, you can look like that. All right, so we done for second note, and let's take some break, you know, and after we come back, we gonna do note 3, and I think everyone got this note 3 already, is that right? Note 3 is gonna be the separations of variable. I posted this one for you on Google Classroom, so you can download it.